What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. It's Monday, the 30th of June, 2025. And we're doing a ride-along today with a prospective new team member who says he knows HVAC and plumbing. Here's one of those service calls. Let me get your thoughts and feedback in the comment section down below when you're done watching. Let's go!
See the windows open. and it's summer, the air conditioner's broken.
Yeah. Real broken.
Yeah, second floor AC is out since the windows are not open on the first floor.
They don't sleep on the first floor. Would it be a second floor AC or the whole thing in this house like this?
House like that, probably more than two systems. Just called him. You'd think he'd be at the front door already.
Yeah. Man, the truth is stranger than fiction, right? You know, you were saying your guy Mike.
Yeah.
Then you gotta. Salt Cavern's a great place. A lot of people out there with very little skills making a lot of money. I was with housing at night and during the day, ESD. Right? They're making 50, that's a plumbing union, $52 an hour. Right? And some of the guys I helped, right? It was okay. Maybe wrong place, wrong time. I'm comfortable there. I speak the language a little bit. Some of the guys that I'm working with, like I got to throw in the kitchen and a drain and snake the drain. I'm like, because a lot of guys, very interesting.
Good morning.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
This is my car, Mike.
Thank you, God. How are you?
Good. Let's see what's going on. Please follow you.
It's not working well. Two things are clear when they don't disappear. It's started up in turn on. And I thought it's just the fan, I didn't put the electric light.
Okay.
And that's maybe a little bit of a detail.
Which one? The one on the left or on the right?
This one.
Oh, you already got the whole thing off already?
Yeah, I think I know the problem, but it's the wife is like, I'm not gonna wait for the parts. Too hot outside, let's take care of it. And I called it and I like,
all right, you want to turn on the thermostat?
Yeah, I'll turn it on. By the way, I removed the electric there when I...
You pulled the plug?
Yeah, it's down there. It's on the floor.
It's on the floor.
You don't know, inside. It's here. Inside, yeah.
Oh, okay. Missing the caps too, I see. Service port caps. Wouldn't be surprised we got a low pressure issue. Yeah, all that dried up like oil, like residue-ish, all in the cap. I mean the threads. It's gutsy to take the cover off and leave it off overnight.
Is it pregnant?
No. Doesn't look like it, but guess we'll see what happens.
You got any help? I try. Double screw on you?
Well, she wants to go.
Yeah.
Did you see that? Yeah,
she
wants to go.
Yeah.
She wants to go.
You could tell.
It looks like it. I could be wrong.
Okay.
It's sending power. So now, I mean, I didn't see the fan take off, so I wouldn't. I'm not connecting gauges.
So what are you going to, how are you going to test it?
I want to take the power off. Take shut the power
Power's off.
Yeah, yeah. Is it all? Oh, you pulled it out?
Yeah.
Okay. So, wait, you got,
I got everything you need.
Yeah.
Okay, I got everything you need.
All right. So it's HM, but I'm not 100%.
So Carrier makes it really good. They make their blue wire common, the yellow wire is compressor, and the brown wire is fan.
Okay.
And they usually make that very very straightforward, but don't take my word for it.
Yeah.
The yellow wire is going to be common. The brown is fan. And the blue, those two blues, is your compressor. And you can normally tell that by the amount of terminals, the amount of, like, spade, you know, terminals on each post. So common right there with that yellow is four. The fan has two. And compressor has three. Okay. All right, have at it. Take it out and put the capacitor out.
You know what? Maybe I unscrew this first.
I have a drill there. And,
yep. Gotcha. Quarter inch.
No, that's 5/16.
Take a deep breath.
Yeah, we're in Woodmere on Central Avenue.
The only reason I did the house, I was looking at that time for Carrier, for the dealership that the new Carrier. The climate was the...
You got the good carriers, too.
The Ken Gilbert and Son were at that time.
Yes.
But I tell you, something happened with them. They were great all those years.
I think they got bought out by a private equity.
You think?
Yeah, I think so.
Because I noticed that now... Real estate is starting to be way more expensive than what it used to be.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I could be wrong, but I think they got taken over by private equity. A lot of contractors are taking buyouts these days because it's I'm waiting for my right number and I'm gone too.
And after they're gonna get everyone, then they're gonna increase more of it.
And then everything will be universal. Yeah, that's what happened. You still have the mom and pops though, but you know, you have, you know, four plus.
Oh, I'm sorry, microfarad. Not on this one. Microfarad tester? Should I even test it? Yeah. The microfarad.
What do you mean, should you even test it?
I mean, no, that's what I'm saying. So this one doesn't have the test.
It does.
It does?
Yeah. Well, you always have the mom and pop still. You know, you still have those small ones. But you have 4-plus trucks, and you're running a good ship, they'll you'll get offers all the time. And again, I get phone calls, like, every single day. Ah. Emails every single day. It's crazy. But I'm pretty sure Gelber, I know Apple, Universe, they all got taken over.
Right, so you say, and I liked them at the time, you know, at the sun was nice. He'd actually put for me the generator at the time. They tried that adventure with the generator a little bit and then they stopped doing it.
2045.
Yeah, we did generators after Sandy, but it's just... All right, hold on. You're not on micro. Sorry, there you go.
Okay, oh, see, I thought that was diode. Oh.
Diode?
Yeah, one direction.
Okay, let's test it.
I don't have the... Well, never mind, I have no excuses.
All right, here.
It should be this one to this one and this one to this one.
Put this down here. Hold this for a second. Hold that. Okay. Watch. We never got to this part on Friday. So we have common and we have herm. What do we have? 28.5, right?
28.5.
And then let's go to fan and go to... common and we have nothing. So this is a 40/5. Let's go find the 40/5.
Does polarity matter with this? I don't know. I'm asking you, right? I'm gonna say herm is... reading 5. Yep. There we go. Close enough?
No such thing as close enough, bro.
It's got to be 5. If you ain't testing, you're guessing.
And you're guessing right now.
I am. You know what? I'm using the herm as my main. I'm using this. This is for the compressor. 42. Then you know what? I'm not going to pretend.
Yeah, don't pretend.
4.5. I'm not going to pretend.
Don't pretend.
So where's my why ain't I getting my 5? Why ain't I getting my 5? I should know that. I don't know that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, there you go. There's my 5.
We didn't get the testing capacitors on Friday.
We probably should have.
We should have. Yeah.
And I'm sorry. Yeah. Because I hate doing that in front of him. Yeah.
It's okay.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Oh boy.
That's why I'm here.
Yeah.
To see what you know, your strengths and weaknesses.
If you weren't here, I wouldn't be here.
Yeah, but you know, it's juice is off, but still, you know, it's good practice. You know, when you're scared of contactors and 24 volts touching something that it shouldn't, you know, you're always exercise caution. And you never make sure that wires aren't going to get close to that. Because if they do, and now you're going up to an attic to replace a fuse, you're not going to be happy on 100 degree day. So we do have a lot of, like, just dust and stuff in here, but we're going to plug this in and see what it does. A la peanut butter sandwiches.
Everything is running, we're doing maintenance. Would you show up and take the temperature to go that old rule of thumb, 15 to 20, take the temperature inside?
On a maintenance, yeah, that's, you know.
Just show up and boom, take that, just to get an idea before you start putting the gauges on, right, 15 to 20.
We only put on gauges when we suspect there's a problem with the refrigerant.
Okay.
All right, let me, I want to clean out the inside of the